People love blank bars, and so do I. I mean, if you can make your video look more like a movie, who doesn't like that? A lot of people, unfortunately, do it wrong because they just add a PNG file to the video and call it a day. And this is all kinds of wrong. Let me tell you why. Don't get me wrong, I am not trying to make you feel bad or embarrassed because I've been there too. I've done this too. Before I knew anything about filmmaking, I thought you could just slap on a PNG file or create those black bars within the program and thought that I achieved that cinematic look that everyone's going for.
Nice!
But one of the biggest problems with this is that when you add bars this way with a PNG file, that it's actually baked into the video once you've exported it. And what I mean by that is that, for example, if one of your viewers watches this video in 360p or maybe even lower because he or she has a bad internet connection, it just doesn't look pretty. And that is the whole point of adding those black bars in the first place, to make it look pretty. If you edit your video in 16:9 and you add the PNG files with the bars, this is what it's gonna look like. The reason is that those black bars give you that widescreen look. It gives you the 21:9 look. However, it is edited in 16:9. So if you're watching this on a widescreen or on your phone, you'll most likely see some space right here. The reason this is because the black bars give you that widescreen look. It gives you the 21:9 look. However, you made the video in 16:9, so it will stay that way, which is why those black bars on the side appear as well. So this doesn't really make your video look more cinematic. However, there's not one aspect ratio that is the cinematic aspect ratio. Cinematic doesn't really mean anything, to be honest. All it means is that you make your video look more like the movies. And movies vary a lot, so there's not one set in stone aspect ratio to make your videos look more cinematic. Just like there is not one color grading that will make your video look like a movie. There's tons out there. And that's the same with aspect ratio, but the most popular aspect ratio is a 21:9. You can change the aspect ratio in every editing program. Don't worry if you don't have Premiere Pro. You can change it in DaVinci, Final Cut Pro, Filmora, literally any editing program that I know, you can change the aspect ratio. But of course, Premiere Pro is my specialty, so I'll quickly show you how to do it in Premiere Pro. When you create a new sequence, you can just pick one of the presets that says 21:9, or you can create your own preset. What you can also do is choose a preset and then go into sequence settings, and here you can change the resolution or the aspect ratio. You'll see that the resolution is 4096x2304. And what this means is that there are 4096 pixels horizontally and 2304 pixels vertically, which gives us a ratio of 16:9. And in order to change that, we have to divide this number by 2.3. Don't worry, we're going to do very simple math. Before we click OK, we want to save the preset. Now we can find our custom preset in the folder custom. So that's very useful in case you want to use this later. Maybe you're asking yourself now, but what if I only want black bars for my B-roll and not my entire video? Well, I'll show you that in a bit, but now that we're talking about aspect ratios, I want to talk about another very popular, very good aspect ratio that is great for YouTube videos, and that is the 2:1. You may have noticed that I recently, I think a few weeks ago, I started using the 2:1 ratio. The reason why I did this is because you can maximize the space on a smartphone. It basically works the same as on a widescreen. Smartphones nowadays have widescreens, and if you upload your videos in 16:9, you will see the black bars here too. But if you upload in 2:1, you don't see those black bars on the sides anymore. It just looks better. And considering that about 80% of the YouTube users watch videos on their smartphone, it's pretty smart to do that. And yes, by changing your aspect ratio to 2:1, you will also get the black bars. They're a little bit thin, but it's still okay. But if you want the actual, the bigger black bars, then go for 21x9, of course. Now, if you don't want black bars through the entire video, which I totally understand, for example, if you're making a vlog and you have these talking bits and then you have B-roll, and when there's B-roll, that's when you want to have the black bars. One way to do that is by adding an adjustment layer, put them on top of all of the B-roll, and then use the crop effect. We go to this tab, effects, and we're going to type crop. Usually I set my settings to about 12 or 13%, depending on how I want it to look. But that's usually what you can go for. This is not the optimal way, because the optimal way is by changing the aspect ratio. But this is a great way if you want your B-roll to have black bars and your talking bits not to have any black bars. If you want to create even better videos or even more cinematic videos, make sure to check out this video. And of course, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell in case you want to be notified, and so we can see each other in the next video. I don't know what I'm doing with my tongue.